It's on the jungle floor that so many of the nasties live. And look, there you go, scorpion. And these guys can move fast and they can strike fast. And you don't want him crawling up your trouser leg when you're trying to sleep at night. But it's not just scorpions. You know, beetles, army ants, and at night time, all of these guys come out to hunt.
John knew the dangers, but he didn't have a knife or machete to build a shelter.
I didn't have very many options until I went round a corner and there was a sandbar, and I thought that might be a good place to stop for the night.
John's decision to sleep on a sandbank was a smart idea. But if you haven't got a sandbank, and even if you haven't got a knife, there's still lots of ways keeping off the jungle floor at night. Pull these vines. And then just wrap them between two trees and make a hammock. And if you wrap it enough times, it's going to create enough strength to support you. Just keep threading it between the two trees until you think it's strong enough to take your weight. Let's try this. And there you go, off the jungle floor, away from the creepy crawlies.
This has been drying for a couple of days now and is ready for me to really work on and use. It's needs a little bit of cleaning up. I'm just gonna scrape the surface, free it from any like little bits of meat that are on it.
Our Stone Age ancestors lived in these mountains. Like them, I've evolved here too, making the most of the resources from the forest around me.
The one thing that man needed in order to migrate up into Europe and in order to deal with colder climates was skins of animals. So suddenly, with this, made into the most rudimentary form of clothing, my life can become comfortable. Cut a head hole along here.
That is so warm.
I really like that.
That's really, really, really good. I've got a warm top. Yes!
Rubbing sticks, Sebastian wasn't having much luck. And even if you know what you're doing, when it's this damp, unless you've got the right sort of wood, it's almost impossible. There are ways to make fire. You just got to be a little bit ingenious and think laterally. You can use a battery, and then even just a stick of chewing gum, you can make fire. Metal foil around the chewing gum. And I want it basically to look like this. So the middle section is as thin as I can make it. And then you connect one end and the other end, hold it together, look, there you go.
Sometimes it's the simplest things that can make the difference between life and death.
If you look after it when it's little, look after you all night long. And that's what these survivors desperately needed.
Wow, that's food.
If I can get past the spines, I'm going to eat this live. Because in the heat, urchins decay very quickly. You only eat the gonads, which are the orange bits. They're packed with protein.
So I can keep harvesting these and munching on them whenever I like.
Not only are urchins a great source of protein, they're also loaded with vitamins, a healthy dose of omega oils, and calcium too.
As soon as the sun goes, the temperature just plummets and fast.
Io ho sofferto il freddo che ancora oggi, quando ci penso, sento freddo. Sento tanto freddo.
Maro remembered his army survival training.
E poi facevo una specie di buca lunga quanto me. La riempivo con queste brace, la coprivo di uno strato, un paio di centimetri di sabbia.
Steadily the heat is gonna come through and heat your core. The important bit to keep warm is just this bit.
Mi ci mettevo sopra e stavo perfetto, come se avessi un sacco a pelo, né più né meno.
You can really feel that warmth coming through the ground now. And normally that's the place where you lose most of your heat. But because Mauro is smart, it's where he actually managed to gain heat from.
Forever wanting to conserve energy, I'm just going to experiment with glissading, or sliding down on my bum, basically. Let's have a go. Not going terribly fast, just him. Oh, nice!
Save a bit of energy.
Sebastian had on him a little Ziploc bag. Good survival is all about being resourceful and using your ingenuity. And therefore, when Sebastian needed a pee, he knew if he peed into the bag like this, it'd give him like an improvised hot water bottle.
I remember taking my gloves off,
putting my hands against it, and I went like this. Oh! Oh my God! It was the best feeling ever. My hands were back.
Oh, that's nice. It might not last long, but just a few minutes of being able to warm the end of the fingers can make a huge difference, not just physically, but also mentally. Warm pee on cold fingers, and that just might be enough to spur you on to the next goal. And for Sebastian, it really did make a huge difference.